Alright guys, welcome back. This is the second YouTube video of this series, and this is going to be going over all of the tank mates in the Leviathan's Reef. Right here we have the boss of the tank. This is a 2 foot long tessellata eel. They are sometimes referred to as a honeycomb moray. These eels definitely are not for everyone. Even being 2 foot long, he is only a third of the way grown. These eels get 6 feet long, are very territorial, and will eat almost everything you put in the tank, or so that's what my research said. I have been kind of experimenting with new additions, making sure to do research first, and so what this video is going to be is me going over some of the additions I have added into the tank and how they have fared with the Leviathan. The very first addition was a cleanerass. In doing research, I found out that these fish can form a symbiotic relationship with ocean predators, in which the cleaner wrasse eats the dead skin and parasites off of the predator, and in return, the predator is providing the wrasse food. So for this instance, the eel is benefiting by the wrasse removing the parasites and the dead skin, making him happier and healthier, and the wrasse is benefiting by having food. And thus, we have a symbiotic relationship. In my research for tank mates that the Leviathan wouldn't eat, I came across what is called a cleaner shrimp. So I purchased one and it went over really well. He started cleaning the Leviathan and doing a good job of it. And so I decided to name him Sancho. He is the same species that is portrayed in Finding Nemo, but I felt like Jacques was just too common. I wanted to be different. So his name is Sancho. It's because of this symbiotic relationship and instincts that Sancho and Jerry remain alive, and the Leviathan does not eat them. Just a quick little recap, we now have Sancho, the Leviathan, and Jerry. The next thing I added to the tank were some corals. This is Xenia, and the red one is a Blastomussa.
Here they are. These are called damsels. What's going to happen to them? They took one good look at the Leviathan and dipped. These are inexpensive, elusive, and often aggressive little fish. Definitely problem fish for most people. I chose them because they can hide and have bright colors. They aren't beneficial like Jerry. So if they can't hide from the Leviathan, they're going to get eaten. One of the damsels was playing with Jerry. Whoops! Almost gotcha! My man's got jukes though! They are definitely cautious about the Leviathan. But if I didn't know any better, it almost seems like the Leviathan wants to play. They hide when I come to the tank, but I was able to get this video of one. He's so close to the Leviathan's chompers. I guess this means they are off the menu. For now.
Alright, as that video just showed, the next addition were two yellow-tailed damsels. I chose damsels because they are cheap, and if the Leviathan eats them, it's not going to be that big of a deal, because they can easily be replaced. And this specific species does have bright colors, so if they are able to hide and be as elusive as my research showed, they would be good additions. The next addition to the tank was a red Hawaiian reef lobster. I decided to name him Larry, just like the character off of SpongeBob. Shortly after this video was taken, he started stress molting, so he is either still molting or dead. It takes lobsters about 1 week to 2 weeks to finish. I had a nano tank briefly set up, but it started to crash, so I had to add the two clowns to the tank. Through all of the additions, I have used an acclimation box, and this is a perfect reason why. Through the slits in the sides of the acclimation box, the eel can smell the fish. This should have been a pretty good warning, because he was investigating the acclimation box pretty hard.
The clownfish explored their new home. Being this close to the Leviathan, if they were going to get eaten, they would have been snacks already. but the Leviathan showed them mercy.
Their names are Pico and Gaia. This is Pico, and she is the boss. The next addition was a gold-spotted rabbit fish. He has venomous spines on his dorsal fin. Here, he can be seen trying to camouflage into his environment, and there is Larry on the bottom, stress molting. Unfortunately, I am almost 100% sure that the rabbit fish got eaten.
I'm also missing Gaio.
Here I am adding a new addition, and I'm dumping it into the net to strain out all the water because the fish store uses copper and Sancho cannot have copper.
I released him into the new tank, and boy, I gotta say, I am obsessed with him. I did research on one for a while and I never thought I'd see one, but just like in the fish store with the Leviathan, I found him.
Due to his red and white markings and the fact that he loves to hide in the rocks, I decided to name him Waldo.
In this video right here, he starts out in the rocks hiding, and then he finally branches out, adventures, and starts swimming around. It's super cool to watch him explore his new environment.
Do keep in mind that groupers are aggressive fish, and this one in particular will grow to be about a foot long. So he's gonna be a big boy.
I think this fish is absolutely gorgeous. I love watching him swim, and he's even taken up a new cave, and it's really cool to watch him go into like his home. This guy is going to be an absolute baddie. Like, he's going to be the top dog in this tank. The Leviathan aside, Leviathan will always be number one, but this guy is easily going to be a close number two, like the Leviathan's right hand man. All right, that's it, folks. You are all up to date.